Isaiah 18, and it cometh to pass when the Lord has not commanded, there is a man that is saying no to the yes of your life. There is a man that stand and say your business will not prosper, but I came as commanded of Jehovah. By this time tomorrow morning, God is about to roast them. God is about to terminate them. You don't serve a dead God. You serve a mighty God. In the same yesterday, in the same today, in the same forever. When God says yes, no man can say no. When God lifts you up, no man can bring you down. God is on your side. Power is on your side. Fire is on your side. Somebody shall fire. Yeah, 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 yeah.
How come when you are strolling around the street, you see sacrifice on the way? It's an altar. There are altars that are erected in communities. How many of you have gone to communities, mostly in Asan, where you have big trees? They will do small shade for something. It's an altar. No altar is just quiet. It's either speaking for or it is speaking against. How many of you were born in a family where they have one thing behind the door? Have you seen houses like that? Behind the door, you just see one small thing. It's an altar. There are communities with altars. There are families with altars. There are meetings with altars. There are all courts with altars. Secret court altars. But child of God, to come out of such a battle, to win in such a war, you need to be connected to an altar. Take those baskets away. Anybody that wants to drop email free, you come to the altar. Because it is altar against
altars.
What am I trying to say? In this life that we live in today, if there is no altar speaking for you, then there are altars speaking against you. It is time to erect an altar. It is time to say to yourself, I want to plant an altar for my family. I don't want to just go out. I don't want to wander like others. I don't want to be used like others. I need an altar. There should be an altar. Something should be speaking for my good.
That the Moabites were fighting was erected by Abraham. Years and years ago, Abraham inherited the altar. Years and years ago. Ladies and gentlemen, let me show you something from God's word. Any man that does not have an altar, his destiny is altered. You know how to alter someone's destiny? Any man or woman who has no altar speaking for him, his destiny is altered. What is an altar? An altar is a point where spirits meet. Spirits and humanity meet. That's an altar. It's a place where spirits and humanity meet. Not just God, not just man meeting God, no. Because evil spirits also have altars. So it's a spiritual thing. It's where man meets with spirits. A man in Irua killed his son in Lagos. How? The man hold jollof rice in his shrine and called his son's name in Lagos. The son began to scream through the night that his father has given him jollof rice. Rice that was prepared in Irua went to Lagos. Somebody had an altar. Some of those food you are eating in your dreams, they are being brought from altars. They project them to alter your life. If there is one thing I know this night, is that every strange altar at work in your family today will catch fire. Man said, how can I curse? How can I destroy God's anointed? How can I fight who God has anointed? How? How can I curse who God has blessed? How? How can I curse them? Ladies and gentlemen, one of the signs that you are blessed is that you have an altar speaking for you. There is the reason why I know that nobody on this earth can kill me as a man is because I have an altar and it's speaking for me.
I just know that no weapon fashioned against me can prosper. I just know that no tongue
rise or reason by before or now or later. No tongue that shall rise against me shall prosper. No. Why? Because there's an altar. When you have an altar, they don't just call you in kingdoms and you appear. No, your altar fights the battle. When you have an altar, they don't just call you in coma and you just appear. They just call you, Matthew. You just say, sir. And they come. No, sir. Your altar takes charge. Your altar takes charge. Your altar fights the battle. Your altar takes preeminence. Take control over your life. How? Number two, how do you erect an altar? You erect an altar by sacrifice. Somebody holler sacrifice. I studied my Bible to understand. Listen to this. This is not because of one thing or the other. I'm telling you how scripture puts it. You erect altar by sacrifice. Abraham erected the altar in Genesis 22 verse 9. It was by what? By sacrifice. How many of you know that Balaam erected 32 altars? 32 altars were speaking against Israel. But yet they could not overcome him. Why? Because there is an altar higher than those altars. You know the problem? Somebody who is fighting you is killing goats to fight you. And you that is fighting against the person, you come to the altar and drop 10 naira. Somebody is killing cows. He's taking your name, traveling from Nigeria to Ghana, Ghana to Togo. How many of you know there are people who are very busy in traveling? Native doctor. They just hear one malam is in Kano. Oh yeah, let's go. The first thing such women does is to put their husband in bottle. They just tell their husband, say, oh yeah, we dey go Kano. Yes, ma. Go buy for a come. Before I buy finish, buy for a come. Okay, madam. Husband. They just go to the market. They tell us, say, go and bring goods. Is it that you want to close that woman's business? Go and bring goods. The woman just tell your husband, oh yeah, Dennis, I'm going to go buy goods. Come. Money still remain for your hand. Change. Oh, yeah, add this one, John. We just drive to the market. They buy the goods. Why they come down? The woman just say, yeah, Dennis, bring the goat. The man, maybe he's a lecturer, maybe he's a doctor, whatever. We just go to the booth. Okay, ma. You see lecturer dragging with goat. The goat will say, I'm not the goat. You say, come here. The goat will say, I'm not the goat. Come here. And then when they bring the goat into the altar, they start splitting the goat's neck. Blood starts gushing out. Spirit starts gathering. And then you, as an individual, you come to your altar. When they have gone to those altar to kill goat, to kill animals, you come to your altar. Strong man, an occult man, is going to sleep very grand 7 days because he wants to drop your job. He has vowed that you will see. And you just say, me, I'm coming with the blood of Jesus. 7 days die, 8 days bury. You will not only see, you will saw. Life is a battle. If they go to their altar, why not go to your own altar? I'm looking for women who can say to themselves, this womb, you will carry a child. 7 days you are doing fasting, waiting on God. You come to an altar, to church, in a specific time of the day to pray. Hannah did it. Stop claiming Hannah's blessing when you have not done what Hannah did. I'll be Hannah. You be Rihanna. Stop claiming a man's blessing when you have not paid the price he paid. These were men of altars. They knew that they cannot do this for themselves. Their husband could not give them children, but they said to themselves, if my husband cannot give me, my altar can give me. Went to the altar and began to cry. I don't have a job. Why not come to the... Have you given God 30 days, no water, no food? Say, no, doctor say, may I wash my weight. Keep watching your weight. If you don't dare to do some things, you can't see the change you want. Dare to do some things. Enough is enough. Your child is SS. We have seen SS turn to AA. It's only a product of visiting your altar. Father, turn this child's genotype. Once it will turn. Am I communicating? I'm talking about the God who you visit. Oh God, help me. I'm talking about the God who you visit. When you visit that God, when you meet with him, he turn your pimple to dimple.
That thing that used to make your face look caricature. How many of you know there are some people when they were young, they used to laugh at them. Oh, boy, see your teeth, vulgar. When God bless you, people can say, come and meet you, boy, I like your teeth. Yes. It's just a product of change. There are some people with big heads. Edward. Edwin. Big mouth. Matthew. Matthias. For the women, Martha. But yet, people sit there and say, man, I just love your big head. I know it's a big head, but I just like it. I just like your big head. I like the way you stammer. Can I stammer like you? That's when God, when an altar becomes involved, your excesses are killed, your little strength amplified. Little strength. Why? Because an altar is involved. You are battling by yourself. That's why things are still the way they are.
If you can make up your mind and say to yourself, I need to be connected to an altar. I need to sleep on an altar. I need to pray in an altar. I need to sow seeds in an altar.
Sacrifice are in dimension. How many of you know that one? I saw one sacrifice yesterday and I was shouting. I went with pastor. When I saw the sacrifice, I was shouting. Can I tell you? When we were younger, how many of you are awake? Why did they put a stone there? Somebody should be hindered. Why would they put snail there? That somebody's destiny should go through delay. You don't place less value on those things. If they could do those things to you, take a seed. A seed that can pay for all those things times two. Drop it in your own altar, Father, as I'm dropping this seed. I'm not talking about putting one picture somewhere and say that's your altar. No, sir. Or burning one candle. No, sir. I'm talking about altar. Where you just know God dwells in this place. God is in this place. You just go there and drop a seed. A man went to Auchi and took a stone from our church. Took stone. Stone. Oh. When he got home, he was not prophesied on. When he got home, he just said, whoever is fighting me, I stone you to death. The strong man shouted that something hit him in the head and died. Why would that happen? The altar there, he didn't walk. The man said before he left, he dropped a seed on the altar for burial. They are fighting with cow. They are coming to church. Tenera. Oh God. I went to a church to preach. It's a popular church in one village. Two people were coming to altar to dance. With tenera, two of them. They were holding tenera half. I thought maybe it's something good. When they came close, I just checked. Eh? Two people with tenera. And when native daughter, your own baba just tell them, say, she good. When you not get one ice, is the burner. There's something I like about those babas. They will tell you things that they don't buy in the market. A mosquito with one feather. A snake without a shield. Yeah. They will first confuse you. Baba, I don't know that, you know. I bring the money now, I'll go buy and come. They are doing their own G. I don't mean the girl level. They are doing, that's the G. A tortoise without a mouth. A tortoise that is deaf and dumb. How will you know? A sheep goat that has never excreted once. Now pampas it away. But hear me, child of God. Show me someone with an altar. And I will tell you somebody who has a future. Most great men, you see, they all have their own altars. Different. Some have negative altars. Some have positive altars. It is time to erect your own altar. Am I communicating here? It's time to say to yourself, I want to raise an altar for my family. I want to raise an altar for my destiny to go far. Hear me, child of God. I am solid standing talking because I have an altar. There's an altar speak. I service my altar steady. Steady. Now, I grew up in a place. I had a friend. This family friend, the father had an idol. Early in the morning, the father would go to the idol. We'll be talking to the idol. Talk to it, talk to it, talk to it. He would cut fowl head and pour the blood there. He was servicing his altar steadily. Thank God the man is saved now anyway. But then he does not miss it every morning. Am I communicating? Every morning must visit them. But hear me. Only Christians take things for granted. Only Christians. They have no value for their altar. They have no value for their self. They have no value for the God who called them. But ladies and gentlemen, only a few I'm about to pray for here who will make up their mind. This is the fourth month of the year. Sir, I want to raise an altar for my family. Only few. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Anyone with an evil decision, an evil projection, an enchantment and a divination against your family by way of one sacrifice or the other, that load will go back to the sender. I say that load will go back to the sender. If your amen is louder, you are the person I'm talking to. From today, anyone who will do a sacrifice negative against you, while the person is putting the sacrifice on the ground, thunder will strike the person there. I say, why the person set us down to put the sacrifice down? Why the person is mentioning your name? Why the person is mentioning your children's name? Thunder will strike that person. A woman called me from the market and said, man of God, they just put an egg in my store. And I said, I can't come, I'm busy. I sent Victor, say, go and bring the egg.
Yes, sir. Yes,
he went
sir.
To bring the egg.
Yes,
I
sir.
Spoke some word and told him to throw away the egg.
Yes, sir.
Minutes
yes.
later, she called back. I said, what's happening again? He said, the person who put the egg has come back.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The person came back and was saying, and yeah, I put the egg just now.
Yes,
I put our person in front.
Yes, sir.
No.
Yes, sir.
And yeah, I put just now. I put our person in front.
Yes,
no.
Sir.
Why? Because an altar was speaking.
Oh.
Before market people. Now yeah, I put the egg. Go.
Yes,
sir. I put our person head.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Anyone who will bring another emergency sacrifice because he wants to frustrate you, you will meet them there. You will meet them there. You will meet them there. Around this area, there was a man, there was a young boy, a boy who was speaking against me. Serious speaking. He does not want to hear anything about me. He does not want to see anybody come around to this church. I just spoke in some syllabic tongues. Few days or few weeks later, they met him putting sacrifice on the ground when they beat him. When they beat him, today if he sees me, Arasa, how are you doing? Why? Water. You don't just it is a syllabus for tongues. Killa Mahande. That killa is English. Mahande is in the tongues inside. A man came here to greet me. It was a counseling period. He came with a jeep. And I said to him, sir, I see another altar with you. And the man said, what do you mean? I see on your jeep, the seat under, there is a charm.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And the man said, a charm. I said, okay, you're asking me a charm. There's a charm. Let's go.
Yes, sir. Yes,
when
sir.
When they will raise seat.
Yes, sir.
On, if you see charm.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, this one. The same man put up for you. It was no longer an imputam. They say me imputam for here. Thank God for this man of God, great man, Pastor Tony. The first day I met him, I said to him, you have a charm in your back by the side cover. He was looking at me like a spirit.
Yes, sir.
When they went to the... Hear me now. Any charm at all. The ones that were buried that you didn't see. The ones that maybe they projected into your life and it has been working negatively against you. I prophesy now that charm will backfire. I said that charm will backfire. Now, can I say this again to somebody?
Yes, sir.
Any sacrifice at all that they have done against you, against your family, against your children, maybe they did it before you were born. Maybe they did it as you were growing up. Maybe they did it even
some few months or few days ago. Maybe they did it some couple of nights ago. Maybe they have done it even while you were coming to online. Today, the person who did that, it will return back to the sender. From this day, an altar will begin to speak for your good. This altar will begin to speak for your good. This altar will begin to speak for your good. Are you shouting amen or you are shouting amen? Are you shouting amen or you are shouting amen? Shout that amen like you know your name. Scream that amen like you know your name. Shout that amen like a thunder.
You need an altar. Hello, Bokoko. Ibagadaba Yagaba. Madam, come. You need an altar. Madam, you need an altar. Ozipaladikia. You need an altar. Come, step out. You need an altar. Okilabara kumzegedia. Elebokondasaya. Igotokodosha. Idukeleke zukete. Madam, you need an altar. There's an altar speaking. Wait, there's an altar speaking against you. Today that altar will catch fire. God is going to erect another. We're going to erect another altar for you. What am I trying to say? The Lord spoke to me that on a certain Friday, your enemy is supposed to die on a certain Friday. I'm trying to look at the Friday of the month. Is it this April? Is it May? Is it June? I don't know. But I'm seeing Friday. And I'm asking myself, how will this, what will happen? Lord, help me. What will happen that they want to take this woman's life? Madam, we're going to pray against accident for you. You know accident? We're going to pray against it. Eh? This is you. I see you. I see you like a businesswoman. Yes. In this business, you go to market, you buy plantain. Yes. You buy plantain.
Yes, sir.
Because I'm seeing your house, I'm seeing plantain.
Yes,
you
sir.
Cover it with cloth. Yes, in something like a basin.
Yes,
in your room now.
Yes.
As you cover it,
thank you.
I see you in the realm of the spirit. I see something like, I see something like somebody come to buy something. And you're looking for change. And you cross. As you cross for change, it's not like I don't know, this is a, where they're selling board or something, beauty material, something like that. I see you cross. You collect change. I see beauty material. I see ply board, all those things.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I see you collect change. As you are returning back, I see ambulance, those convoy that are going for burial. A car pick you among them. And your enemy fall to the ground. You need an altar. Every disaster package over me. Every disaster. Every disaster package over me. Every disaster. 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 Somebody tell the neighbor, I need an altar. Shout it, say, I need an altar.
I need an altar.
You're not saying it, say, I need an altar.
I need an altar.
Brother, no matter our package, no matter our package you are, you need an altar. Oh, God, help me. No matter our package you are, you need an altar. Somebody is speaking against you. Somebody has to speak for you. Alaga, 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 alaga. Idigi, digi, 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 digi. Hear me. I say it again. Anyone who an altar is speaking against, today, heaven will swallow up that altar. Maybe it's a family altar. Maybe it's a community altar. Maybe it's an altar that an occult man is using to fight you. I prophesy again to you. That altar shall be swallowed up by fire. This year, when people are talking about good things, testimonies, your own will be double. I say your own will be double. Madam, are you the only one here? Are you alone? Oh God, help me. If they don't want to talk, let me move. Ujaba aba lebo go go. Obili bili bili bili. Ilabada bada bada.
Oboru, can I pray for you, sir? Did you come here alone? Eh? You came here alone? Okapatala. Idogodo. Where's your wife, sir?
She's at home.
Eh?
She's at home.
Sir, you need prayer.
I know.
A lot of prayer. Because there's a battle you are going through now. You are confused. You don't know what to do anymore. Are you with me, sir?
Yes, yes. That's why I'm here.
You're in a state. I'm seeing a lot of things happening negatively. Anything you put your hand now turns against you. Anything you put your hand turns against you. There's this. Listen, the way God just spoke to me now, I spoke to him. Anyone here who has a strong man or a strong woman making you go through what you're going through, between now and Friday, they are dead! In the name of Jesus Christ. From this altar, I make a decree. Between now and Friday morning, at most Friday, between now and Friday morning, they shall die. In the name of Jesus. Strong men. Strong men who have wasted your life. Strong men who have wasted your time. Strong men who have wasted your destiny. Strong men who wants to make you nobody when you were born to be somebody. Strong men who want to ridicule you, who want to waste you and make you futile. I pray for you today in the name of Jesus Christ. The God who killed Pharaoh, the God who killed Herod, that same God will kill the strong men. That God will kill the strong men. Jehovah will kill the strong men. My Father will kill the strong men. Jehovah will kill the strong men. In the name of Jesus. 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 There are about 45 people here. I just heard that to tell you that the strong men, they are dead. The strong men, they are dead. The strong men, they are dead. The strong men are dead. Listen, in that your family, where no one has been able to achieve anything good, where no one has been able to achieve anything good, in the name of Jesus Christ, you that will shout this amen, I turn the curses in your family to a blessing to you. All the causes. The same you they said nothing good can come out of. The same you they said cannot become something. If I be a servant of God, if what I hear is Him, if what I hear is Jehovah, this month of April, something good will come out of you. Your identity is changing right now. Your identity is changing right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Someone will hear a news. And the news is that the strong man is there. I said the news is that the strong man is there. Whatever you have been battling with for years now, today you are free from it.
Thank you, Lord.
Lift your hands. You are awesome in this place. Mighty God. You are awesome in this place. Abba Father. You are worthy. You are worthy of our praise. Let to you I raise.
You are awesome in this place. Mighty God.
Mighty God.
Awesome in this place. Mighty God.
You are awesome. of 75. Who is Odama? Who is Odama? Is that a name or something? Who is Odama?
Odama is my grandfather.
Is your grandfather?
Yes, sir.
Your grandfather's altar is speaking against you. Your grandfather's altar. Can I tell you how he's speaking against you?
Yes, sir.
Number one, are you in school?
Yes, sir.
Hey, you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Can I tell you something that he's doing against you? No matter how you read, does not enter.
That is true, sir. That
you are struggling with it, and it's affecting your results.
Yes, sir.
Your father's shrine, your grandfather. Your grandfather used to have something called Osu. Osu. It was disturbing everybody in the family. Today, in the name of Jesus, that altar is destroyed. Now, anyone who has a deity, or you are connected to a deity, in one way or the other, deity is destroyed. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray for you today. The grace that turns life around, that grace is released upon you. That grace is released upon you. What no one could do. Sir, you are going to experience favor. Eh? The Lord is going to bless you. I'm seeing you're going to walk in a very wealthy place.
Amen.
And you are going to also, like I see a call of God upon you.
Amen.
You are called, but you are going to walk in a wealthy place. Who is in Lagos?
I'm going back to Lagos.
You're going back to Lagos?
Yes, sir.
Who's there? Who's there in Lagos?
My brothers are there.
Your brothers are there?
And I also stay there.
I see God giving you a land in Lagos.
Amen!
Let me show you. You don't think I'm joking. You know where they call Aja?
Yes, eh? I know Aja.
You know Aja? As I get to Aja, I see a particular shopping mall, a complex, and the Holy Ghost is showing me a woman who is having an issue. This woman is a member of Redeemed Christian Church of God. And I see God, because there's a lady connected to your life. Through this lady, we're just going to pray for this woman. I'm still having a problem with issue. Eh? Issue. We're going to just pray with her. She's blessed. She's going to get pregnant the moment you pray for her. And she's going to ask you, what can I do for you? Because I see her own a mall, like a shopping mall. I see she attend Redeemed Christian Church of God. And she's going to dash you because she's buying properties. She's going to dash you a land.
Amen.
And on this land, when the land comes, it's not your own. It's God's own. Yes. As you give God the land, you'll be having buildings in Lagos. Buildings.
Amen.
I'm prophesying on you on what will happen. Mark my words. Mark today.
Yes, sir.
In Lagos State, you will walk on wealth.
Amen.
You walk on favor. If God is speaking to one, he can speak to another.
Yes, sir.
Wherever you are in this auditorium, believe in God for a landed property. This year, 2016, amen. Carry your land.
Amen.
Now, those people who need what you carry, ay, ay, ay. No matter what you think you do, there is something you have. And there is somebody who need what you have. This week, next week, between at the end of the month, we'll meet with people who need what you carry.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
People will be begging you for assistance. You. The prayer, the anointing you carry, when you lay hand on them, it will function.
Amen.
The money they carry, when they lay it on you, your life will change.
Amen.
I wish I was speaking to somebody. Thank you, Father. I speak grace upon you. Man of God, I release grace. O kapa, eledosh. Sir, stand. Stand. O lele kolaba. O rabataya. Have you ever sat down to think of relocating your church?
No, sir.
Eh? You have not thought of relocating your church?
No, sir.
I'm seeing an issue in your church that we need to pray about. Leko apara. The Holy Ghost opened my eyes and I'm inside your church now. As I get into your church, there's a particular church that was close to your church. I see close.
Yes, sir.
The church close. Like fold up. I'm not seeing it, but,
It's happening.
I'm not seeing any people in the church like that.
There's a church at my back.
At your back?
Yes, sir.
I'm seeing people leave.
Yes, sir. Eh?
And I see somebody in the church tell the pastor, that is you. That is using charm to draw his member.
The pastor is saying so.
The pastor said so?
Yes, sir.
And I see now, we are here in all night. On Sunday night, after service, on Sunday night, they have to rub something on your church. You are supposed to go there within the week. For something like, I don't know, understand whether it's canceling your program or something like that.
Go there Monday, Friday for night prayer.
I'm seeing something like, they are saying when you step there, they're going to afflict your legs.
I go there Mondays and sleep all alone. Pray.
You sleep all alone
yeah.
in the place? But I'm seeing something like, they have rubbed something on your church door. They've rubbed something. You know, I'm seeing your church, I'm seeing grief. Like a grave close to church.
There's a grave at the other plot.
Eh? Yes. Grave. As I'm seeing the church, I see them rub something on the ground. That when you come, you have to pick it up. That when you start running from one another, you will not have time to concentrate on your church.
I was supposed to be there 2 Mondays now, but my spirit said I shouldn't go.
You shouldn't go.
Thank you.
Sir, can I tell you what will happen? As I'm here now. Both the man and the pastor who could knife to frustrate you. This year, the church is closed. See, I'm not saying this because it is good to close churches. No. Anybody with a wrong mind is not of God. It's not of God. You know, I'm seeing E in his signboard. E, something like E.
Of man or the other
person. E, him. I want to call the full name of the church. I'm seeing E. I'm seeing C. I'm seeing E, something like that.
Yes. Eh? Yes.
Don't call name. Calm down. Can I tell you what will happen? It is youth of the community that will break that board. Now, you know, the problem of a pastor is a pastor.
Yes, sir.
The problem of a manager is your fellow manager. Problems of students are fellow students. Anybody in your capacity that is fighting today, they shall be disgraced. Today, they shall be disgraced. I speak to you. I speak to you today, sir.
Uh-huh.
Your church, we must. I speak grace upon you. I speak greatness upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Tell you what you will do. I'll tell you what you will do. Take 2 days. Eh? Dry. Don't eat. Don't drink. Anything. Tell God who called you to remember you now. The God who called you. So share something with you. You're a pastor. You're a man of God. God called you. The errors of the past will not fight your destiny. The person that raised you, when he opened the church, it will grow. It will close. It will grow.
Yes,
it will fold up.
Yes, sir.
It will grow. It will fold.
Yes, sir.
You know now, as the Lord is showing me something, that's also an agenda that they plan for you.
You're right, sir.
Eh?
You are right.
That agenda we cancel now.
Amen.
Sir, on Sunday, I see 4 youths coming to become your members. These 4 youths, they will carry all the load on their head. There is one thing I thank God for in this place, that God has given me people who carry the same hearts that I carry.
Yes, sir.
They carry the burden of the fellowship. Like before I come, I could call, okay, fix the amp, test the amp, do this, or I will come and do it by myself. But now, I just come and then start preaching. Why? Because God has given me people with the same heart that I carry. 4, they will locate you. From 4, they will begin to multiply. You meet with the right people. And you have an anointing. When you pray for people, they get testimony and they go out. They
yes,
don't
sir.
Share it.
Yes, sir.
They don't share it. There's somebody who promised you, I'm seeing a woman, who promised you, her daughter is in Italy.
Yes.
You prayed.
Yes.
Papers. I see papers.
Yes.
But right now, I'm not even seeing her in the church.
They don't even call me.
Today, you are remembered. Nina, I pray against fortification. by the power of the Holy Ghost. Stand up, sir. Carry your children. You will carry your children. You know, I'm talking about sacrifice. Somebody carried egg, rotten egg. You know, cocoa area. Cocoa bay. Eh?
Yes.
Somebody carried rotten egg and went to hit it on the road. And said, you will never hear the cry of a baby in your house. Go and lay down on that altar. Tell your God that you want your baby this year. Oh God, can I just continue like this? Holy be the Kaya. Father, help me. You are the Lord, you are the Lord. You are the eyes I used to see. You are the
key that opened my door.
You are the
owner of my soul.
The bush that bore it
never comes to you.
What shall I render
to you, O Lord?
Oh,
I will bow down and worship your name.
Your name.
You are my Lord.
Sir, you're on glass. Can I pray for you? Is taking it out of you. Low sperm count is destroyed.
Amen.
I see a report. The devil is a liar. It's an attack from hell. It is destroyed in the name of Jesus. I was talking to that man about children. You will carry your children.
Amen.
Go to that altar and say, God, I will carry my children. Ayah Kalaba. There are babies on the altar. If you are believing God for a child, just touch the altar and touch your stomach. Just touch the altar and touch your stomach. Wonderful Jesus. There is grace on my head. I prophesy grace. You are the reason why I lift my head.
Why I lift my head.
Why I sing to you. Jesus. Thank you, Father. What village are you from?
I'm from
you come from?
Yes, sir.
This village?
Yes, sir.
You are not from village, you are from town. This place is not town. Eh? It's not town. You are not be town?
Yes.
Where did the town when are there? Only light not there now. Even Lagos light not there, Lagos. That's why I hate all those places. No light. I like light. There's something I'm picking in the name of the Spirit. It's only you and your family. Where's your mom?
She's at home.
Your dad also?
It's late.
Pray for you.
Yes, sir.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
The Lord is telling me tragedy. What happened to your dad?
Sir?
What happened to your dad?
He was very sick.
Was very sick?
Yes.
That's how he died?
Yes, sir.
What is the land? You are home. This same person, you will pray that they should not deport him. Because your village, you should not deport this, or your city, because everyone is a city. This man is like the light everybody's looking at. But by the power of the Holy Ghost, may the Lord preserve him in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, this picture is a Nigerian picture, Abi. Nigeria.
He came to Nigeria January.
Came to Nigeria January.
Yes, sir.
What I'm trying to say, this one does not look like abroad. Okay, how then did I know?
He was in Nigeria January.
Okay, he now told me that he was abroad.
No, sir.
I thought he came to Nigeria to tell me that he was abroad. But God will show you favor. I see your mom. Pray for your mom because of her leg. I see a particular leg of hers that's giving that challenge, like pain in this area. Pray for your mom. She told you.
Yes, sir.
Pray for her.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Sister, you're holding somebody's picture. Hold this picture. But somebody rubbed a cream on you. In the name of the Spirit, somebody rubbed cream on you. And this cream will make man come and go. Man come and go. Can I pray for you?
Yes,
the Lord deliver you. In the name of Jesus. Elakunda. Do not listen. It's not, watch out. It's not everybody's powder that you use. It's not everybody's cream that you rub. Be careful. Bible says even for nothing. What you are suffering now is a friend's cream. A friend's cream. Not knowing that she put things. She went to somewhere they put things. Rub. Affecting you. Today, that cream backfire. In the name of Jesus. Now there's a sister who wants to take a trip to Libya. There's a sister. This one is not me. I'm seeing a sister. You have prepared to go to Libya. Please, I'd like you to come. I want to see you. I see a sister who wants to take a trip to Libya. Libya. Because you want to go to Europe. And somebody who has... This is a sister. A sister. Your daughter wants to. Your daughter is on the road.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Lord.
That guy's mouth open. Wait, stop. Is he, his mouth is open? Seriously?
Yes, sir.
I will just snap that and put on Facebook. Please wake him up. Why are you videoing? Come on, move camera there. Yeah, the guy has come back. Oh God, help me. Where is the lady I was? Your daughter is on the road, right? Are you aware your daughter's friend carried her to travel?
No, sir.
You're not aware. Did he tell you she was traveling?
She did tell me before I left.
Did she tell you she has got you to Libya? Did she call you?
Yes.
She called you? That what?
That she's not in Saba.
Saba? Wait. Your daughter is not in Saba. Your daughter is in Mali. They have deceived your daughter. You have deceived your daughter. Your daughter is in Mali. Not in Saba. Mali. Can I pray for you?
Yes.
I used to pray for your daughter. Right now, wherever she is, this night, let her wake up. Let her escape them. In the name of Jesus Christ. Whoever is using her mind, controlling her, today, let fire locate that person. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Jesus name. Sir, you be careful of who you marry. Can I continue?
Yes, sir.
Because it will go a long way to organize your life. Sir, and there's something you are still going to do. You know properties? You know properties like agents? Like agents? You know agents? Like
agent.
Property something?
Okay.
Yes, sir. You know something like that? Like those who do, what do you call them? Wait, there's a name for it. Estate management. No, it's not just estate management. There's a name. Housing agent. There's another name. There's a package, a more package name for it. There's a package name for it. Caretaker. It reminds me of Sunday. Somebody came to give testimony that they just made him caretaker of his house. that he has been there for 15 years. Landlord just made him caretaker. My east when I east. Who gave that guy mic? That's what I was talking. Not that the landlord dashed the house. So encourage you to keep staying. The Lord is going to bless you because right now I'm seeing people who you put your hope, none of them helped you. They all forsook you. I'd like you to go into properties. Look for somebody. Go into properties. Go into properties. Properties market. Property marketing. Estate agent and all that. Look for somebody who knows it. You have a grace. You are easily trusted. People entrust things to you worth millions. They will entrust their secret to you. It's a grace. The Lord put it on you. You could use it for something else. Property. The Lord wants to bless you. And he says you go into that line. I release it on you. Fulfill destiny. Now, sir, be careful of who you settle down with. Can I say it again? Can I say it again?
Say it again, sir.
That's been your pain. Be careful of who you settle with. Because you are a calm person. But the woman Satan is preparing for you is a bagbati. He will control you. Satan has prepared her. Delilah, they learned for where she did. For me to tell you that, you know, There's something left now. Like okay. Wait, is the person in church?
No, not in church, but she attends.
Is he in church now?
No, not church.
She's not here now.
But she attends.
Is she in church now?
No, sir.
She's not in church now. Okay. I talk anything?
No, sir.
I mention name?
No, sir.
Not my real face, so. How many of you have watched that comedy? It's very funny. You know what? I see a trait of control. Somebody trying to control. Somebody trying to make decision. Huh? A woman, every woman should be subject to the husband. It makes life beautiful. Huh? No matter how many degrees you have, you are still a woman. Hmm? If you must fulfill destiny, if you must fulfill destiny, your wife matters. Don't make a wrong choice. It doesn't matter the church the person attends. The church is not the problem. The person is the problem. Eh? That's the issue. Father, may you not make a mistake.
Oh.
In Jesus' name. God bless you.
Thank you, Lord.
Mama, ya. Hey, it's your name, yo. Sele? Sele, say, remember. Why you wear white? You are finished eating my money at home. You came to wear white here. Alpha. You are planning to eat my money. Holy Ghost fire. Wonderful people. You told me you will come to church. You have come. I hope you have come to stay, not just visit. I hope you didn't escort people here. And you, even you. Desmond. Endurance. Change your name. Endurance is not a good name. How many of you know? You keep enduring, enduring, enduring. Change your name for endurance to something else. If you want to be enduring, enduring. Before you choose a name, or if you have a name, check the meaning. I used to have a name. I asked what's the meaning. They say it's a dove. Me, Leke Leke. For what? I changed the name. So you're the best. Change your name and call me. I'll dash you money. Jesus name. Hello, sister. Can I pray with you? I pray with you. Eh? From today, you'll be celebrated. Stand up. From today, you'll be celebrated. You'll be celebrated. Can I tell you why? Eh?
Jesus.
When it's time for them to play, they will not play. When it's not time, they'll be playing for Abumo. Hello. God help me. Thank you. God will bless you. Because he said you have been working for him. Are you a chorister?
Yes, sir.
A chorister?
Yes, sir.
You're not just a chorister. I'm seeing position.
Yes,
eh?
Yes, sir.
Your position.
Yes, sir.
What? Like, is he a leader?
Ah. Yes, sir.
You're leading BB people. I'm seeing BB people. Even women, like, a lady there, you, seriously, shake my hand. So you know how to sing. You know how to sing. What? I-N-E-T-I-A.
Nidia.
What's that?
That's my son.
Thank you.
Give me your hand. Give me your hand.
Oh.
From today, God will show you favor.
Amen.
God will show you favor. You know that sometimes even to have your uniform, sometimes is a problem because of lack of finance.
Yes, sir.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
I pray for you.
Oh.
You meet with people who will help you.
Amen.
You meet with helpers.
Oh.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Put your hand in your stomach. Because the devil knows where you are going. They afflicted your stomach. Now, you try to fast. Problem. It's a problem for you to fast. Eh?
Yes, sir.
Chronic ulcer. Under here. It's gone. You will not feel it again. See, you can be singing and forget eating. You like songs. I'm singing right song. Eh? This year 2016, I prophesy on your head. May you be remembered. In Jesus' name. Madam, who took your name to a native doctor? Eh? You Patara Shh Dakaya. Reboba Sigodoya and Netokomba. You have a child? Where's your child? That's your child. That's your child. That's your child. How come I'm seeing man face this side? You and child face that side.
Yeah, correct, sir.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
I'm seeing man face this side. I'm not seeing marriage, oh. I didn't see marriage. Mm-hmm. Eh?
No, sir.
You face this side. The man, there's like a disconnection.
Yes, sir.
Eh?
Sir.
But the man lied to you.
Yes, sir.
He lied to you. It was later after something has entered that you now saw the truth.
Yes, sir.
You know you. You were supposed to terminate this child.
I was one, several in the dream.
You were supposed to terminate this child and you would have died. Even him, he didn't want the baby and all that. But this baby, this one, the laughter your family has not had, this one will bring it.
Thank you, Lord.
And you have suffered. But your suffering ends in 2016. God will send you the right man.
Amen.
You suffer to the level. There are things I can't go deep, but I'm seeing them like him. I can't talk about them because of people. There are things you did that you didn't want to do.
Yes,
but situation pushed you into it.
Yes,
you know a hotel? I see a hotel.
Yes, sir.
You were in a hotel. By the power of the Holy Ghost.
Ah.
2016.
Ilaba.
See, sister. A man will come. This man that will come, when he comes, he will change your life.
Amen.
In this same town, you will own car.
Amen.
In this same town, you will own lands.
Amen.
In this same town where you have been. Now, even your siblings have rejected you. I'm seeing people who have money, they've rejected you, turned their back on you.
Rich.
Eh? Rich people, they travel. Eh? See, can I pray this prayer for you?
Oh.
That of them this night, as I'm talking, that they should wake up and be thinking about you.
Amen.
Can I do it? It's done. Jesus' name. It's done. Can I pray for you?
Oh.
Eh? Did you come here alone? Where is he? Orakala zebohodosh. There are things God is going to do in your family. This year, 2016, between May, June, he's going to turn lives around. He's going to turn lives around. There's going to be a dew of greatness pouring upon your family. In Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Lord. Allah
Tala. Philolosh. In broken lalabash. O tolaba. Ivrogodosh. Somebody saw me in his dream. And there was a warning. There was a warning. About something. I don't know who this person is, but somebody in the revelation. You have a child? Come here. Eh? You don't have a child? You are here alone?
It's my brother.
You have died with your brother?
Yes.
Where's your dad? Is your child? Is your child?
Yes, but I go with my brother, this man.
This one is your child.
Yeah, it's mine.
Wait, I'll talk about that, but this one is your child. You are my strength. Bring him. You are my strength when I am
weak. You are the treasure that I seek.
Oh,
you are my holy Lord.
Oh. Is Where's your brother now that gave birth? Amen. Wait. Wait, sir. Sometime it will be okay. Sometime it will come.
Yes, sir.
He will start misbehaving.
Yes, sir.
He will start some things.
Yes, sir.
That's why they beat him.
Yes, sir.
Wait. Where's the woman who gave birth to this child?
He left his husband.
Left the husband.
Yes.
Which other woman now came?
The father take it to worry.
Which other woman now came to the father? Which other woman? The stepmother.
Yeah.
Who is this one to the father? I'm trying to explain something. Who is this one to the father? Which number of child is he?
He's a second son.
Eh?
He's a second son.
Yeah. Who was in school?
That is in the school.
Where is he now? Sir, I'm seeing this man's madness sponsored by a woman. This man is seeing spirits. You'll be talking, see something.
See this one.
See him. That's what happened to him.
Yes.
A woman is cooking this boy. Anytime they put the boy on fire, the madness will come. This boy is bright. This boy is eloquent, sharp, but the madness has destroyed him. Every season, they will make him mad. Eh? Can I pray for him? You believe in miracle? Okay, watch. Mother Telenesh, Alaras, Erodo Godo Sudo. How many wives did your father have? Stand up.
Father.
Your father.
My father have two wives.
Two wives. Your father have two wives.
Yes.
Who is at Uyele?
This small one. When my father get accident.
Who is at Uyele? Just mention. The second wife is at Uyele.
Yeah.
The second wife is at Uyele. Wait to Madam Oga. Wait. Who is in Palace? Onoje Palace.
My father is a chief.
Your father is a chief.
Yes.
Who is on a lady bike?
My father.
Who is? Wait. I'm tracing something. This battle. You are talking about this man. Your own. We need to pray for you. You. Your wealth has been buried. You are struggling. Nothing to show. Sir. If you want your life to change. Family house. You're not supposed to be in family house.
Who is living
in family house? I see family house.
I live, but I work in my family
house. Who is living in family house?
I'm the one living in family house. We work there. I work in my family house, but I don't live there.
Do you have a house?
I have a house.
When did you build it?
I built almost 2 years ago.
Have you completed the house?
I lived.
You have moved there.
I live there.
To your house.
I do my work in my family house.
Do you work in your family house?
Yeah.
I'm seeing something like a family house where you are struggling and something is not coming out. Because this is you. They almost killed you now. You almost died. Wait, let me count the death. You almost died. And God saved you. Accident. Out you rode. Something like somebody transporting.
Yes.
Transporting. They almost killed you. You almost died. God saved you. Because a woman wanted to eat you. This time now, you are hustling. What you have been able to do, nobody in your family have been able to do it now. Nobody. You are like a landlord. God accepts you as a landlord, as you have said.
Yeah,
because what I'm seeing now, I'm seeing family matter. Family matter. Wait. There is a child of yours there's a small child, eh, who somebody from north, you know, Aboki. I say Aboki with material. You know, material, those clothes they sell on his head as he's dropped material. I said, I'm like your son. Talk to him wrongly. And he says he would deal with your son in the ninth. It's an Aboki. You have a brother. I'm seeing somebody who is stubborn.
It's true.
You have Aboki in your house.
Yes.
I see somebody quarrel with Aboki, and Aboki has said he has called Manam a knot because he wants to destroy your son's
it's
life.
True.
I'm talking to you. This is your son. I'm seeing somebody. What they plan now? He will come from school and run mad. Eh? The person I'm seeing, as I see, sister, I see him have problem with Aboki. Cause Aboki, like,
it's true.
Abuse Aboki.
He's evil here.
He's here?
Yes, sir.
Bring him.
Thank you, Lord.
You? Come on. Amen. Are you aware about what I'm just saying now? Eh?
Yes, sir.
Bros, what's your Aboki do you? Tell me the truth. Ma, pray for you. What do you do?
Nothing.
Why you cuss her? Eh? I want to pray. See, tell me the truth. No, not fear anything. Come. Eh? Tell me the truth. I'll pray for you. Yeah? I don't want to meditate and destroy your destiny. Yeah, what do you talk? Oh, yeah. What do you do you? Eh? You dey sleep. You know, may I leave you, may you go. May I not pray for you? May I pray for you? What you happen?
No, my trouble.
If, look for your trouble. No. Not truth now. You can't look for your trouble. What you can't tell her? You can't curse her. God help me. This one has gone foul. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, let every go back to sender.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy on this one. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
It is well with you.
Amen.
Jesus name. Bros.
Amen.
Not because you're senior again, yeah? Because this person I'm saying vow that I would destroy this one. It was even this fellow, this is, look at what this, because this one, he abused and finished. You know when somebody abuse somebody, finish. Look for your trouble. You get trouble. If you sit there, you don't get trouble. Makatala Ozia. You are too young. How old is he? It's close to 12.
Yes.
Never ever reached 12. You're getting close. I declare your words. Your mind restored. Jesus' name.
Amen.
Can I pray for him now? Yahweh. Where would I be?
Not for you.
That's why I sing.
I worship you.
Lord, I lift him before you. In the name of Jesus Christ, let the spirit of insanity disappear. Let madness go. Back to your sender. Anyone who wants to destroy his star just because of envy of his future, let that person receive such destruction now. I command the spirit of madness, go in the name of Jesus. 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 From today, your mind be sane. Your mind be normal. In Jesus' name we pray. Give me chance. Give me chance. Give me chance. Give me chance. Stand up, come. Come, stand up. Come. Come, come, come on. People beat him like this. Aye. Come. I hope you don't worry. Come. Wait. Well, don't give me space. Pastors, hold him. Hold him, Osas. Hey, wait. Move your leg. Move your leg. Move that one. This one is paining you, right? Did they pain you? Eh?
Yes, this one is.
It's paining you. Wow. What's that? Did they sew it or what?
No.
Is this cordless?
No.
Jesus Christ. And see, it's not about the people, it's about the woman who puts him where he is now. It's the woman who puts him where he is that this arrow should go back to. Yeah. All these things, Nashit one, Nashit manipulator, all these things. Aish, yeah, it's okay. Who is in Jehovah's Witness?
Jehovah.
Wait, two. Wait. God help me. What is it? It's not him. I see something inside your witness. I don't want to talk further because the way you reacted just now. You are free in Jesus' name.
Amen.
From this day,
The
hand of God shall protect you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you, Lord.
I want to talk to him. Can I talk to you? You talk to me. What's your name?
My name is Gosway.
Gosway. That's your name. Who did this to you? Huh? Who beat you? You don't know them. And they beat you like this. The Lord heal you. Lord restore you. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord.
So he's free. I want to see him on Monday.
He's
free.
Miracle.
Hey, can I talk to you? There's a guy. He does, you know those lacacera? You know lacacera? All those things. That's what the guy does. Disconnect from him. Eh? What will you gain if you get pregnant this year? Eh? You are young, go disconnect from him. You hear what I said? The Lord help you. Jesus' name. Are you blessed? You sure?
I am blessed.
I didn't hear you. I said, are you blessed?
I am blessed.
Are you blessed? You are sure you are blessed? Can you scream, I'm blessed?
I'm blessed.
Shout it at the top of your voice, say, I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
If you can shout it more than your neighbor, then you carry the biggest blessing.
I'm blessed.
You are blessed. You are blessed. So, are you married? You are single. You are searching. Are you single and searching? You are searching. You have not seen one. Ah, so his sisters are just looking at him. Chai. Please, if you want to see him, is he not good looking? He's good looking, huh? He's a half caste. Celebrity. Ah. If you want to see him, see me. Through me. I'm the links man. God bless you. God bless you. There is a blessing awaiting you in marriage. Yeah? Work towards settling down this year. Walk toward it. You have decided to follow Jesus. Get set to settle down. You'll be shocked. I speak helpers around you. In Jesus' name. I speak helpers. Who works in council, local government? I don't know. Is this revenue or something? No. Do you do revenue? You know what's revenue?
But I have a friend that works in that place. We stay in the same place.
I'm hearing something else. Revenue. What's revenue? Revenue. Tickets.
You work in that place before.
You worked there before?
Yeah.
What did you put in for any job that you have not gotten answer?
That day, I left the place I went to.
You work as revenue collector?
No. I left the place. I went to Lagos.
Did you work as revenue collector before?
Yes.
You worked as revenue collector
before? 5 years ago.
5 years ago.
Yeah.
You left there. You went to Lagos to work as a driver.
Yes.
And now you came back.
Yes.
What are you doing now?
Nothing for now.
For now? May God give you a job. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord.
Work toward marriage. Lo ukufra asaya. Sister. You know what God said I should tell you? You want to be a widow?
No, sir.
You don't want to?
No, sir.
The Lord said I should tell you to forgive. Drop the picture on the ground. God said I should tell you to forgive.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You don't want to forgive?
I will forgive.
You forgive. Now, if Jesus comes, what happened? You want to cry? Don't cry. If Jesus comes now and you don't forgive, go to hell. Will you be happy? Eh?
No, sir.
You won't be happy. Don't cry. Calm down. Let me talk to you. Did you speak to anybody here before?
Sir.
I will speak to you, but I'll keep some things for security reasons. Eh? If you don't forgive, you will end up a widow this year. But if you forgive, your home will be intact. I'm seeing your husband betray you.
Yes, sir, it's true.
Betray you.
Yes, sir.
You trust him.
Yes, sir.
He turned back and hurt you. You are thinking of two things. If to kill yourself.
Yes, sir.
Shh. Now, do not react until you listen to the truth. Calm down. You want to kill yourself? Don't kill yourself. Don't kill yourself. You thought of two things. You say you want to use knife. You say, okay, you will buy poison. Or whatever, you commit yourself, whatever. Now, calm down. Forgive him. You hear what I said? All will be well.
Yes.
Hi. Don't cry, girl. Don't cry. Please now. You're pregnant.
Yes, sir.
Somebody else is pregnant.
Yes, sir, for my husband.
Don't kill him now. Don't kill yourself. Don't kill. Now, some people did not hear this story before. They were just, It's not her fault. It's not her fault that she thought like that, but that's not the right choice at all. I look at Nigeria. I didn't see your husband.
He travel out.
Travel out. How come your husband will call you, will not pick? You're tired. You're angry. But are you telling me now that you're forgiving him?
Yes, sir. Eh? He begged me.
You beg him, he beg you. You forgive him.
Yeah.
He beg you. Sorry, yeah. Sorry. Can I tell you something? You know, I live in Nigeria. I'm always good in living in Nigeria because I want to live in Nigeria. I want to live there. Man, but that's the way that I want to live there. I thought they go so. Sister, I live in Nigeria. I get to. Okay, I live in Lagos, which is Murtala Mohammed Airport. Philip, no, Philip, Arik. Arik, now I use. As I left Arik, I landed in a place called Kenya.
Yes, sir.
Nairobi, Kenya.
Yes, sir.
I see your husband crying. Even your husband is crying.
Yes, sir.
Your husband likes you. But the problem is, foundation pushed him to do what he did. Are you aware his father did not have one?
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. And it's like first son, like first son.
Yes,
what's that?
Thank
it's,
you.
It's not him, it's foundation. What you should do is to pray for him. Killing yourself will not help him. See, if you don't forgive him, God will hear your cry and will judge him. But you will not be happy. Forgive him. Let him come back. Because he's even afraid to come back. He told you he's afraid. May God help you. May God have mercy on you. May God have mercy on you. Lord, have mercy on this family. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh. Are you blessed?
I am blessed.
Are you sure you're blessed?
Oh.
I will minister to you, bro.
Yes, sir.
Seriously?
Oh.
Idi mano tutu.
Oh. Ikwe siri tukwasa obi Jehovah
Oti oye ni kagi.
You know one thing I like about choir? When they hear me sing a song, they go and learn it. When I just read the song, they will now sing it more than me. The next song I'll be singing is tongues. I will do.